Hi friends, welcome back to another video of Artha Institute of Management. This is one of the video on our educational series, and today's video we are focusing on a topic called mini constitution. Artha Institute of Management is a company secretary coaching center based in Palghat district in Kerala. We are one of the leading company secretary coaching center, dedicated company secretary coaching center in South India, and we have classes for CS executive entrance test as well as for CS executive. Then CS executive classes, offline classes will start in the month of September, and online classes for CS executive entrance is going on. Today's topic is mini constitution. There are many questions coming in when we learn, when we try to learn constitution, and with regard to amendments. One of the amendment is called the major amendment in the history of constitution. And this is also called, and after this amendment, the constitution is called, or this amendment is called mini constitution. Why so? And what are the situations led into the drastic change in the constitution? That we are going to discuss here. Constitution as adopted have faced many amendments in the years which has gone. There are more than 100 amendments happened in constitution. Amendments means there's some small changes or some changes which will make the constitution more effective. That's what actually the amendment is all about. But what 42nd Amendment happened in 1977 was one of the major amendments happened in the history of Constitution. This amendment has changed the Constitution drastically with regard to articles and with regard to application, with regard to control, with regard to supremacy, and every aspect there were changes. That is why this amendment is called 42nd Amendment, mini constitution. Now, we'll go to the time period when it has happened. This constitutional amendment has happened, that is 42nd Amendment has happened in the period of emergency. And the period of emergency happened from 25th June 1975 to 1st March 1977. Indian National Congress was ruling. Indira Gandhi was the Prime Minister. This particular amendment is one of the notorious amendment. We can call actually, there are a lot of discussions happened on this amendment. Prime Minister Indira Gandhi want to regain her control and want to see that the parliament is supreme than the Supreme Court or the president, because she was facing setbacks in the political front. Later, these amendments, most of the amendments have changed in the 44th Amendment. But anyway, let us discuss the situations which led to this major amendment, mini constitution. This particular amendment, which came into effect from 3rd January 1977, most of the amendments came into effect in the month of January 1977. Why this 42nd Amendment? That's what actually we want to know. What are the situations led to this particular big amendment? One of the main aspect of amendment was the constitution must be living. That means you should adapt to the situations. Actually, the one of the reasons which they have told, which has led to the amendment of the constitution drastically, to ensure that the amendment is, the constitution is a living constitution. That means the constitution is changed, adapted to the changing situations. Of course, it should be. One of the second reason listed by the government was, we need to add the high ideals of socialism, secularism and integrity of the nation into the preamble. Actually, till the 42nd Amendment, the preamble of the Constitution doesn't have the words socialism, secularism, and integrity. But by 42nd Amendment, these words have been added. And these got predominance over the fundamental rights. Actually, the form of Constitution has affected with a big change by adding these three words. So this was another reason the government was put into. Then, till the 42nd Amendment, the Constitution was not talking about fundamental duties of the citizens. But the 42nd Amendment was intended to create fundamental duties for citizens. Like you have the right, you have duties. A duty of the citizen is which is clearly mentioned in the 42nd Amendment. And this particular amendment, the fundamental duties, has added one of the important or most controversial addition. They're supposed to add this. What is that? That is the special provisions for anti-national activities, whether it is individuals or associations. So the government got free control. Government want free control to list out the activities which are anti-national, and what are the precautions what the government can take or actions the government can take against individuals and associations. Hope you are, when you are reading today's newspaper, like recent time newspapers, you might have seen the sedition case and the JNU case and all those things. These are the these are has happened only because of this particular amendment. Happened in 1977. Now, another reason what the government was telling is the parliament and the state legislature is created by the will of the people. So the parliament should have supremacy over the our Supreme Court or President on constitutional amendments. That means when the Parliament amend a constitution or a provision in the Constitution, it should not be questioned in Supreme Court, because the Parliament should have the supreme power. The supremacy of the Parliament was to be established. Then I don't know whether you are able to understand what is going to happen if the parliament is supreme. So there are a lot of negative things which can happen, like what is happening in the neighboring countries, in our neighboring countries. Then, even if the laws passed by the state or the Supreme Court or the constitutional amendments was to be contested in the Supreme Court or High Court, the parliament want to see that it should not be contested in high courts, it should be contested only in Supreme Courts. And also, there should be 2/3 majority of the judges to see that this particular amendment is not valid. To say that this particular amendment is not valid. That means a simple majority is not enough. There should be minimum 2/3 majority. That means the parliament can ensure in most of the cases the amendment is unquestioned, not at all questioned, not at all like rejected by the Supreme Court. Then another reason the amendment was intended to make, to establish administrative tribunals for the speedy trials. Like now we have this National Company Law Tribunal, National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, Competition Commission, a lot of things, right? So this type of administrative tribunals has to be established for speedy trials, ensure that these corporates are not facing the delayed judicial decisions. Actually, in India, we used to say that if it is a civil case, it will take minimum 20 years to decide. So that should not happen. It should be a speedy trial should happen so that the companies, not the organization, the management, or the corporations will be able to run smoothly. and some other amendments. And these are the reasons why the constitutional amendment was proposed. And what happened in the amendment, that we should see. Actually, these were the reasons why this amendment is proposed, or the situations which led to this amendment. And what actually happened with this amendment? This amendment added the words. Actually, our preamble was telling sovereign democratic republic. So the words changed from sovereign democratic republic to sovereign socialist secular democratic republic. That means the socialist secular has been added. Entire constitution has changed. Socialist secular has been added. And the words unity of the nation was substituted with unity and integrity of the nation. The word integrity is added. Hope you remember, like 2 minutes before I told, like the by the word adding integrity, by the word integrity is being added into the constitution, the government want to see that they have free power to control individuals or associations against whatever they are saying about the country, the nation. So unity and integrity of the nation has been substituted. That was a major change in the constitution. And the scope of Article 31C has been increased to add even the directive principles. So you know that directive principles of state policy cannot be contested in the court, because the directive principles of state policy was the foundation for creating fundamental rights. If a law is made on fundamental rights, that can be contested in the court. But you cannot contest a directive principle in the court. This is what is the law says. That is what the intention is. That is why 1973, the Keshavananda Bharati case has happened. In the Keshavananda Bharati case, it is clearly Keshavananda Bharati versus State of Kerala, the case is clearly established, the rule that the directive principles, the basic structure of the constitution should not be changed. That means it should not be contested in the court. But this amendment has changed by adding Article 31C to the Constitution of India. The particular feature has been taken out. And made this directive principles of state policy can be contested in the court. It's a drastic change. Drastic change. Then, there are three new articles added, 39A, 43A and 48A. There was a beautiful article added. It provides for equal justice and free legal aid to economically backward classes. Participation of workers in the management of industries. Historians say this has happened only because of the influence Sanjay Gandhi had in the parliament, in the government. This particular provision has been added. Participation of workers in the management of industries and protection and improvement of environment and safeguarding forest and wildlife. Good additions, I feel. It's a good additions. This has been added to the Constitution. Article 39A, 43A and 48A. Now, new Article 31D has added for making of parliamentary law to prevent or prohibit anti-national activity or anti-national association. Article 31D, one of the controversial, and still it is controversial, still this particular explanation is controversial. See, the parliament law, the law will be created in the parliament to prevent or prohibit anti-national activity or anti-national associations. And one of the main point in this Article 31D, it is further provided that Article 31D will not be deemed to void on the grounds that it takes away or abridges any fundamental rights conferred by Article 14 and Article 19 and Article 31. That means, if a law has been passed on a person, making him liable to be prosecuted for anti-national activities, he cannot claim the protection of fundamental rights under Article 14, Article 19, and Article 31. This was a major change. It's happened. Major change. That is a human rights violation, we can say. In that situation, this is going to be trouble. This has been added. But that is very reasonable when we look from the side of a country and the nation. Like if you allow freely people to talk about against the country, against, say, they can do any activities against the country, nobody is going to prosecute them, there is no liability from their side. So that is going to be very dangerous for the nation. So that is why this 31D has provided for this particular thing, that Article 14, 19, 31 cannot be, the protection under Article 14, 19, 31 cannot be claimed by people or associations who are charged with, we can say, sedition or anything, anti-national activity. Then, one more article has been added, that is Article 32A has been added to provide the Supreme Court will have no jurisdiction. The Supreme Court doesn't have any jurisdiction to decide the constitutional validity of the state law in writ proceedings. See, actually, this constitution amendment, that 42nd amendment, taken out all the powers of the Supreme Court to review a law passed by a state. Part 4A of the Constitution has been added. Part 4A to Article 51A has been added, which mentioned about fundamental duties of citizen. Then Article 74(1) has been added or amended to make the president work in accordance with the directions of the Council of Ministers. That means this amendment made the president the puppet of the Council of Ministers. So the president cannot take any decisions. Article 77 and Article 166 relating to union government and state government have been amended to provide no court or authority will be entitled to require the production of any rules framed for the transaction of government business. That is another amendment. Article 77 and Article 166. Union government or state government have no court or authority should ask the governments to produce any documentary evidence for the government businesses. Authoritarian. Article 102(1A) provide that a person will be disqualified if he holds a office of profit under government of India or state government or government organizations. But the power to disqualify them has been conferred only to the parliament. Only the parliament can disqualify. Article 83 and 172 has been amended to increase the period, the duration of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha or Legislative Assembly from 5 years to 6 years. That the political situation of the particular time, they want to see that their power is extended for another 1 year so they can plan for the election. That was the reason. So the duration of the parliament, the Lok Sabha and Legislative Assembly has been extended to 6 years. Then, it provides union government. The union government, this particular amendment has provided for the union government to have power to deploy personnel, armed forces, in any part of the country where they feel grave situation of law and order. So they will decide what is grave situation of law and order. In that situation, they can have the personnel, armed personnel to be deployed in any state. The federal structure of the constitution has been touched. And the writ jurisdiction, the Supreme Courts and High Courts writ jurisdiction has been restricted. The power of the writ jurisdiction. You know what is writ jurisdiction? That has been reduced, that has been curtailed by this amendment. Actually, one of the major aspects of 42nd Amendment, that is a mini constitution, which was made effective from January 1977 during the period of emergency, was to see that the parliament has got supremacy over the other part like judiciary and executive. That means the president and Supreme Court or courts doesn't have any power. They can do anything. That was the core idea of this particular amendment. This has actually made the government to feel that actually they have become more powerful. There were a lot of conversation, discussions, deliberations, arguments against and for this amendment has happened. Later, the future actually, what has happened is Indira Gandhi failed miserably in the next election. And 44th Amendment made a lot of changes into the 42nd Amendment. Whatever the powers have been curtailed in 42nd Amendment, most of the powers are restored by 44th Amendment. One of the point what I want to say here, in 1983, there was this famous case, Minerva Mills case, Minerva Mills versus Union of India. This case, actually 1977 to 1983, that means the next 6 years of Supreme Court or High Court had the curtailed power. Minerva Mills versus Union of India case, it is established that the Supreme Court or High Courts have the power, the judiciary have the power to call any amendments on any grounds to check whether the validity of that amendment, the intention of the amendment, and also to see that the fundamental rights or the directive principle of state policy have power over the fundamental rights. The power of the Keshavananda Bharathi or decision of the Keshavananda Bharathi has been restored by this decision. So this is what actually the 42nd Amendment or mini constitution is all about. I tried to explain all the parts of this, and still if you have any doubts, you can put that doubts in my comment box. I'm very happy to answer all those doubts. And if you like this video, don't forget to like it and share if you feel like any of your friends or relatives may use it or may need it. And subscribe my channel, because I'll be uploading this type of videos regularly. And thank you very much. Wish you all the very best.